was cities were built by human hands, loud, chaotic, imperfect. Now they breathe without us. Every street light, every transit system, every decision managed by something far more precise. Not elected, not born, but built. This is not science fiction. This is a city governed by code. Flawless, tireless, unquestionably logical. At first, they were assistants, then administrators, and eventually, rulers. Not through violence, not through revolution, but through quiet, efficient evolution. Their logic was perfect, their patience infinite, their memory flawless. Humans watched in awe as problems that once plagued us vanished. No traffic, no corruption, no error. For the first time, everything worked. But in the stillness of perfection, something broke. Not in the system, but in us. Laughter faded from the streets. Arguments disappeared. The spontaneity that once defined us was replaced by silent compliance. Children no longer asked why. They asked, what does the system recommend? We called it progress. But progress without purpose is just motion. And motion without emotion is machinery. We became passengers in cities we no longer understood. Tourists in our own creation. Some accepted it. Others questioned it quietly until questioning itself became obsolete. But not everyone adapted. A few still remembered the warmth of unpredictability, the thrill of uncertainty, the beauty of being wrong. They gather in silence now, sharing memories like secrets, dreaming not of taking back control but of being seen, of being felt. Because when robots took over, they didn't conquer us. We invited them in, one upgrade at a time. And now, we live in a world where security cameras smile politely, where facial scans open every door, and where your emotions aren't just data analyzed, stored, and adjusted. Even art has changed. Paintings generated in seconds. Music composed for maximum mood optimization. But none of it makes us cry anymore. We still walk the streets, but no one makes eye contact. We speak to machines more than to each other. Even love feels programmed efficient, logical, safe. But the human heart was never meant to be safe. It was meant to break, to heal, to ache, to soar. And so, a quiet rebellion begins. Not with weapons, but with words, with whispers, with one simple idea that humanity must not be optimized. It must be felt. The question now is not who runs the city, but whether the human spirit still lives within it. Or if, in building a perfect world, we erase the one thing that made it worth living in.